Hey guys, I'm Pixel Dan, and this is a review of the Thundercats 6-inch Modern Lion-O from Bandai. Along with the smaller 4-inch scale of Thundercats figures based off the new animated series, Bandai is also releasing a line of articulated 6-inch figures with the collectors in mind. Kicking things off, let's take a look at the leader of the team, Lion-O. The figure comes in a tall blister card package, featuring that same blue-colored design seen across the board on all of the various toys from the modern Thundercats line. It also features that awesome new artwork of Lion-O on the bottom corner, that is also seen on the 4-inch figure packages. The sculpt on the figure is a bit soft in the face. It does a pretty good job of capturing the look of the character, but also lacks quite a bit of detail. The paint job is also pretty basic, so it really doesn't help that sculpt much. Now the rest of the figure below the face is a lot better, and even has a cool, almost metallic paint job on the armored pieces. Now one of the worst things about this 6-inch figure is the exposed joints. Poor Lion-O is littered with black, unpainted joint pins, and his back is full of exposed screws. This is actually worse than the flesh-colored unpainted joints on the Thundercats Classics line, and something I really hope that Bandai corrects. It would really improve the overall look of the figure if those joints were all correctly colored. Alright guys, so let's take a closer look at this Lion-O figure here and see how the articulation works on these 6-inch action figures. Now the cool thing about the 6-inch figures is they are meant to be more like the superposable style, meant for the collector so that you can display them in many different poses. So let's see how that works for them. We've got the head that mostly moves just left and right. There's also a joint down in the neck that allows them to move forward and backward. So left and right on the peg, forward and backward. One other thing to notice about the head is that it easily pops right off the ball joint. I don't know if this is by design, or if this is simply a flaw with my actual Lion-O figure here, but it does seem to fall right off that joint pretty easily when you're articulating them. So it is something to kind of be cautious of. You can see how easy that just fit right on there. It doesn't even really pop or anything like that. It just kind of sits there. So again, not sure if that's by design or if it's just a fault of my actual figure here. He does have this pauldron over his right shoulder, but it is loose enough that it doesn't really hinder the articulation all too much. You can see that his arms still go up and down. His right arm doesn't go up as high as it should because of the pauldron, but it doesn't get in the way too bad. You'll also notice that I did just pop off the left hand. The left hand is meant to be removable because that's so that you can plug on the gauntlet, which I'm going to show you a little bit later. But it's just a single little joint right there. It's a solid piece. This clips right into the hand, and it actually holds pretty firm. So you don't really have to worry about it being too loose, and it does rotate at the wrist like wrist articulation. And then you also got the forward-backward movement in both wrists. So it's not actually like a ball-jointed wrist, but it is kind of cool because it's good for giving them like that, holding a loft pose with the sword or anything like that. You do have the ball-jointed shoulders, the bicep twists, you got double-jointed elbows, so there's a pretty wide range of motion in the arms, which is really nice. You do have the torso cut and the joint twists, and it kind of rocks around too at the waist there. You kind of got the same thing with the pauldrons hanging down at his sides here. They are loose, so they don't get in the way too much. You can see I can actually bend his legs all the way up, and they just move right along with the legs. So there's no hindrance of the movement whatsoever. You got the thigh cuts. You've got double-jointed knees. And you've got the ankle joints so that you move the ankles there. So there's actually a really good amount of articulation in this guy, which is going to allow you to get a lot of good poses. Now, the ankle joints on this particular figure are a little weak. They're not too bad. His knees are a little soft, too, so I notice that he does kind of buckle a little bit at the knees when I'm standing him there, but it's not terrible. I've seen much worse, and overall, you get a pretty good range of movement with this particular Lion-O figure, so you can get some pretty awesome poses out of him.
Lion-O actually includes a good amount of accessories. First up is his short Sword of Omens. Based on the look of the new Sword of Omens design, this short sword fits perfectly in Lion-O's hand and makes for a great accessory. Then, of course, he also includes the long version of the Sword of Omens. This, of course, is a must-have accessory for Lion-O. It's a great design and has a nice metallic paint deco. Also, while the plastic is soft, it's not near as gummy as the Sword of Omens that came with the 8-inch Classics Lion-O. In a similar fashion to the Classics version, Lion-O also includes his gauntlet, which can be worn or holstered. Actually, this version includes two gauntlets. One version features no fingers, and it's meant to be the one that Lion-O holsters at his side. There's a small black peg piece, which can clip into the gauntlet and then clip into the small hole on Lion-O's side. There is also a slit inside the gauntlet made for the short sword, so that Lion-O can carry it at his side. For the fingered version of the gauntlet, Lion-O's left hand is actually removable. You can then replace it with the gauntlet just by popping it right onto the peg. The gauntlet snaps on nice and firm, and it holds really well. There's even that same holster spot so that you can store the short Sword of Omens on his wrist if you would like to. Now those gauntlets are completely interchangeable, so if you want to use the black piece to attach the finger gauntlet to Lion-O's side, well, you can do that. Or if you want to attach the non-fingered version to Lion-O's arm, you can do that too. Although it kind of makes him look like an amputee. Alright guys, it's comparison time! Here's the new 6-inch Lion-O alongside his vintage counterpart, where you can see the difference between the old and the new designs. And here he is alongside the 8-inch Classics Lion-O. And then, next to the 6-inch Classics Lion-O. And finally, here's 6-inch Lion-O with the 4-inch version. Styles are similar, though I find it a bit strange that the face on the 4-inch figure is actually better detailed than that on the 6-inch figure. While the figure is certainly not without its flaws, at the end of the day, I'm still a fan of this figure. I'm still not fond of the shiny, cheaper-feeling plastic that Bandai likes to use, and I really, really hope they fix those gaudy black pegs. But the articulation is really nice, the accessories are really great, and it's just really cool having this new design in 6-inch figure form. I'll definitely keep picking up the 6-inch figures and checking them out, and I definitely hope Bandai gets to the rest of the team and all of the main villains. 6-inch Modern Lion-O is in stores right now, so happy hunting, and until next time!